You have the pararenal fascia. Pararenal fascia. After that, you have the renal fascia behind the pararenal fascia, and then we have the perirenal fat. Perirenal fat. And the, above the surround that covers the kidney, you have the fibrous capsule. This is the fibrous capsule. It's about the fat and the fascia transversalis. And then the arterial supply and venous drainage. It's the hilum of the, in the medial part, it's the hilum of the kidney. The hilum of the kidney, the most anterior stretch of the hilum of the kidney is renal vein. Renal vein. And it's drained into the inferior vena cava. After that, the renal artery. The renal artery, it's the renal artery, divides into three branches. Two branches are directly posterior to the renal vein. Two branches. The others, the third branch, are posterior to all the structures of the hilum. All the structures of the hilum. I need two main branches directly posterior to the renal vein, but the others posterior to all the structures of the hilum. And also to the ureter, as we talked about, ureter has three constitution. When the pelvis of the kidney, when the constant pelvis of the kidney join the ureter, here you have a constitution. And when the ureter cross the pelvic ring, and also when it enters the urinary bladder. And also we have the testicular vein. Testicular vein in the right and the left are different. In the right directly drain into the inferior vena cava. Testicular vein. But in the left, yes, the left testicular vein drain into the left renal vein. Also the testicular artery arise from the abdominal aorta. And if the internal structures of the kidney is composed of two main parts, cortex, and the medulla. Medulla is composed of many pyramids, and medulla have a apex toward the cortex and a base. It's the base. Yeah. The apex. As the base and the apex. With the base toward the cortex of soil. And the apex. And the when the cortex toward it, it's called renal column. Here is renal column. And it's the ureter. Pelvis of the ureter, when it enters the hilum of the kidney, change to major calyces. Divide into two or three major calyces. Each major calyces divide into two or three minor calyces. Here the apex toward the minor calyces, but the base toward the cortex. And above, this is the renal vein, most anterior, the renal artery. After the divide into segmental branches, the suprarenal vein, gland. I think that's all. Fibrous capsule. Directly surround the kidney. After that, we have the perirenal fat here, and then we have the continuation of the fascia transversalis, renal fascia. At the most outside, you have the most exterior, you have the pararenal fascia. Here, the pararenal fascia. Relation of the kidney, you can get in the snail, because we just talked about practice. That I can't say about it. The relation of the posterior, some of them, relation of the posterior, psoas and quadratus lumborum. صورتنا في القرآن قدرت سلام بالقرآن إليو هاي بوغاس تريك إليو إنجواني they talked about the relation really but you have the source and quadrate cerebellum in the posterior to the kidney and the anterior talked about the in the right to left right flexion in the right you have the duodenum and also you have the right lobe of the liver but you can't get it still. That's all.